Get your backpack ready. It's time to brainstorm another trip. This week in our whirlwind tour of the history of science, let's travel to Asia. I hope you'll make some meaningful and unexpected discoveries this week as we explore the strange new world of science in China, India, and Japan. Though we have just a limited time to visit, we'll not be like tourists in Beijing who seek out fast food at McDonald's. Our aim will be to get to know pre-modern Asian scientists in terms of their own place and time, not just in terms of modern science. Do you remember the 2008 Beijing Olympics? The opening ceremony reflected the history and culture of China. What do you appreciate about Chinese history? A few weeks ago, we mentioned the Silk Road. What do you find most interesting about pre-modern interactions between the cultures of Asia and Europe? A few weeks ago, we also mentioned the Great Wall of China. Have you ever seen it? What do you know about the Great Wall? What most interests you about the history of China, India, Japan, and the other regions of Asia? Do you read or speak Chinese, Sanskrit, Japanese, or any other Asian language? What are your favorite works of Asian, Indian, or Chinese literature? Does Asian, Indian, or Chinese history have any special meaning for you? What is your favorite movie or book related to Asia? What do you enjoy about Indian, Chinese, or Asian food? Do you recommend any restaurants in the area that offer authentic dishes from these countries? Have you visited China or India or any other country in Asia? Do you or your friends have family ties there? India was the birthplace of Buddhism, the world's first great missionary religion, which spread to China in the first century and remains the largest organized religion among many Chinese religions. Key concepts in Buddhism are karma and nirvana. When karma ends and nirvana is achieved, there is a cessation of physical change and being. Have you read any Buddhist writings or modern Buddhist adaptations, such as Hermann Hesse's Siddhartha? India is also the home of Hinduism, another of the five great world religions, along with Judaism, Christianity, and Islam. Karma is also a key concept in Hinduism, along with the guidance of a guru. Hinduism is largely pantheist and teaches that the physical universe and the self are illusions. Have you read any of the sacred Hindu writings, such as the Bhagavad Gita? What have you experienced of or do you know about these religions? How might they have shaped the science of Indian and Chinese cultures? As always, when we're planning a trip, we want to better understand what the people in this place and time were up to. What are some similarities between Asian cultures and our culture today? How might these similarities help us to understand Asian science? And what are some differences between Asian cultures and our culture today? How might these differences pose an obstacle to our understanding of Asian science? What do you think might be the chief barrier or prejudice that obstructs modern appreciation of science in Asia? Can you name an Indian scientist or a Chinese scientist who lived in the time period of this course? If you are unfamiliar with Chinese, Indian, and Asian scientists, why do you think this might be so? What would you most like to discover about them this coming week? Please share your thoughts on these things. What are your starting assumptions?